Good morning, Jets. This is actually Principal Strickland's favorite holiday song. So, of course, I had to take the last day of break to play my favorite holiday song. And I hope you all have been enjoying our holiday spirit that we've been trying to sprinkle upon you here at Charles Hart Middle School. So, here we go. So please listen up to a few morning announcements. Today is Tuesday, and here at Charles Hart Middle School, every day we will ensure a safe, challenging, and inspiring educational experience for all. Our mission is leading change, challenging minds, transforming lives. I want to give a big happy birthday shout out to three special students who are celebrating their birthday on today. I want to give a big happy birthday shout out to Alexis Davis, Marcellus Whitfield, and Darion Wyatt. They're celebrating their birthday on today. So it's the last day heading to break, so I might as well celebrate the people who are having their birthdays from now until the end of the year. Big happy birthday shout out to two students who'll be celebrating their birthday on Christmas Eve. Brandon Taylor and Peyton Washington will be celebrating their birthdays on Christmas Eve. And three people will be celebrating their birthday on Christmas Day. Big happy birthday shout out to Lawane Chandler, Imani Fields, and Zareek Tinker. So they are Christmas, well, those two are Christmas babies. Tariq Zinker and Xavier Young will be celebrating their birthday on the 26th. So a big happy birthday shout out to all of our Jets who'll be celebrating their birthday through the 26th. And after the 26th, you can look on social media. I'll be posting some other birthday celebrations. So stay tuned and keep following us on social media. All right, tomorrow, just because I love you all so much, the Live School store will be open. I will be at Charles Hart Middle School from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. At 2 p.m., Principal Strickland is rolling out because I got stuff to do. So come up and purchase items from the school store using your Live School points. If you don't know how many points you have, you can ask your teacher. You can send me a message in Canvas, and I can tell you exactly how many Live School points you have. All right, big shout out to Christopher Beverly in the 7th grade. He won our quizzes competition on yesterday when we took our little quizzes on Christmas movies during advice. So, Christopher, stay tuned. I'm going to be sending you your gift card. All right. So, the year wouldn't end well if Principal Strickland didn't give her final thoughts on this year and everything that's been going on. First, I'm going to share my Christmas memory that I shared with my advisory yesterday. So, one of my most vivid Christmas memories wasn't about a gift that I received. It was about a moment in time for me. I was in middle school, probably the same age as some of you all. And my mom and dad, for all of my life, all of my childhood, all worked at R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company. And so where I'm from in North Carolina, it's a big deal to work at this factory because they pay well, they have great benefits, and it's stability. So this one particular Christmas, my dad said, you know, I just want to let you all know that I lost my job. And because, you know, I lost my job, I don't want us to feel like it's going to impact our Christmas and things going forward. And he was just like, I want to let you all know this so that, you know, we can plan and we can understand and just appreciate the most important thing. And that's us being together. That's us having our health. And that's enough. And it made me realize that in that moment where, you know, it's devastating to lose a job because you don't know where your meals are going to come from. You don't know how you're going to be, where you're going to be able to live. But understanding in those tough moments, it's our mindset. It's how we move from it, how we look at it. It's how we rebound from it. And that moment showed me a lot about my father. And it was about, you know, I'm not going to be down about this. We're going to celebrate where we are right now and then plan and look for what the future will be. And I say this to you all and say, like, we all have a lot going on in our lives. We're dealing with death personally. We're dealing with illness personally. We're dealing with loss of being around our friends, loss of not seeing our family, loss of our lives being what we thought was normal. But how we rebound from this loss, from this death, from this illness is our mindset. What do we think about it? Do we see it as, oh, this is going to take me out. I'm never going to be able to recover from it. Or do we take it as, this is this moment right now, and how I focus my mind, how I focus my heart will determine how I get out of this. And I just ask you all, in the middle of everything that's going on, and we're dealing with a lot. You all as students are dealing with a lot. Your families are dealing with a lot. But our mindset is what keeps us, is what tears us down at the same time. And so in everything in life, I always ask you, please look at the brighter side of things. Look at that this is just a moment right now. It's not the end. And so since this is not the end, we have tons of days, years, moments, seconds that we still have to make sure that they're joyous, that they're full, and that we appreciate them. So appreciate where you are right now, even though it's not perfect. And understand that it's just a moment right now. But in that same space and in the whole hoopla of it's about to be a new year and new year, new me and all of that good stuff, what I always say is your mindset determines what your new year will be. And I'm going to just be honest and I'm going to own some of my own stuff. Principal Strickland can't expect to lose weight if she frying pork chops every week. Like, no, it's not going to happen. Like, you can't expect to get all A's if you do no work. You can't expect to be a future millionaire if you don't put in some work. So if that's investing, if that's researching, if that's saving, if that's coming up with a plan, like everything in life is a lot about everything you put into it. So for those of us who have these grandiose goals that 2021 is going to be your year, then it's about putting in the work. And so that's kind of what my theme is going to be for next school year. And next school year, we're going to get back into our conversations about the 7 habits of highly effective people. But I want us to say 2021 will be great because we're going to put in the work. And that's it. It's about the work in our mind. It's about being diligent, being dedicated. We are, and we may not feel like it in some moments, but we're truly in control of our destiny, of our future, of our minds, of our hearts. Like, we control that. Nobody else does. And so I ask during these next couple of days, because it's not even weeks, you all, this is like the shortest break ever, that you think about, like, what are some of the things that I need to work on to be a better me? What are some positive thoughts that I need to say to myself on a regular basis to keep me motivated, to keep me from feeling depressed, to keep me from feeling down? We have to own and control that. And lastly, what you put out in the universe is what you get back. So I ask you, please, during these next couple of days, do something nice for someone else. Like, this is the spirit. This is the time where we're all being generous and we're being giving. We should practice that on a daily basis. So if you see your neighbor outside struggling to bring groceries in, go outside and help them. If there's trash in your neighborhood or your courtyard, pick it up. If you know somebody needs their spirits lifted, give them a phone call, send them a text message, say something nice, do something nice, and that is what we get back. So I ask you every single day, tell you, encourage you, do something nice for someone else, and not just in the hope that it's going to come back to us, because it makes you feel good. Like, I actually enjoy being nice, having a positive energy, because I feel good. I don't like when, like, oh, I'm feeling grumpy or depressed or things are not going my way. I don't like how that feels. So it's about controlling your weather, controlling your mindset. And I tell you what, 2021 is going to be an amazing year at Charles Hart Middle School. Why? Because we're going to put in the work. Yes, I'm gonna put in the work. You're gonna put in the work. And we're going to have an amazing year. So to close out going to break, I had to do a little phone dump, and I just wanted to share some of, not all, but a few moments from 2020 from Charles Hart Middle School, some highlights, some fun things, and this is not everything, especially for those of you all who are new to Charles Hart Middle School, but here's a few things that I found on my phone that I think you all would enjoy. I love you all. I hope you all have an amazing, restful break.